Speaking of which, it seems no one enjoys India's company like Russia does. The two countries have had a close relationship for decades. Trade between New Delhi and Moscow has risen to a record high. Russia is India's second largest source of crude imports and the biggest defense partner. They're also widening maritime cooperation, and all of this would not have been possible without guarantor Prime Minister Modi. We are not the ones saying it. Russian President Vladimir Putin is. He has heaped praises on the Indian Prime Minister, lauding him for what he calls tough decision-making. He has also pitched for trade in national currencies. Here's a report.
I cannot imagine that Modi can be intimidated, threatened, or forced to take any action or decision against the national interest of India and the Indian people. I know there is such pressure on them. I am aware of that.
Vladimir Putin can't stop praising India. He has hailed Make in India. He has called the G20 PM Modi's personal success. And now he's back at it again. Yesterday he was addressing an investment summit. It's here that he praised Prime Minister Modi once again.
The relations between India and Russia are constantly developing in all the areas. And the main guarantor for that is the policy led by Prime Minister Modi.
So why is the Russian president wooing India? One reason is the historical ties. The second is the current political atmosphere. Tensions with with the West are at an all-time high. Russia is under multiple sanctions. The world is under pressure to pick sides. But India has remained neutral. It has called for peace. And it hasn't stopped buying Russian oil. The West put a lot of pressure, but India refused to bow.
India is mostly getting preferences due to discounts on Russian energy resources, and that is the right thing to do. To be honest, I would do the same in their spot.
India and Russia are old partners. The two countries have a long history of military cooperation. Russia is India's largest supplier of defense equipment, even though the sales have dropped. In the past decade, Russian arms sales to India dropped by 65%. In 2022, it was worth $1.3 billion. So, while sales may have fallen, it's still a big number. Then, there's trade. In 2022, it was $35 billion. And in just the first half of 2023, it's already $33.5 billion. So, trade is clearly booming. And now Putin wants to take it further. He wants to use national currencies for trade.
We should work on the financial infrastructure. We need to use more national currencies in our mutual transactions.
This is a statement that might excite India. Earlier this year, India and Russia suspended efforts to settle bilateral trade in rupees. This was after months of negotiations. It's because Moscow and New Delhi have a high trade gap, and most of it is in favor of Russia. So Moscow believed they would end up with an annual surplus of rupees, almost close to $40 billion. Plus, the rupee is not fully convertible, so it never worked out. Now that Putin has mentioned it again, maybe it isn't the end of the road for the rupee-ruble trade.